eating real good food. They fed the Air Force. The Army Air Corps had the top-notch food because they didn't want you to get any gases in your stomachs when you're flying, because that's miserable when you get air sickness. And I never did, but some of the guys did. Tell you just a little side story, you know, on it. It's kind of personal, but I think people will enjoy it. I will keep it on the upper echelon, and I will call one number one and one number two. And most people know what number one is. You use a leak tube for that. And number two, you know what that is. Just don't set on a metal can and get the, don't put the paper or the plastic around it, because when you get up, if you set on it up there at 25,000 or 30,000 feet, you're going to have a nice round circle around you know what. I have to tell you a story about the waste gunner. It's kind of, and I'll keep it pretty clean. For some unknown reason, he liked the English dark ale. And for some unknown reason, I always told John Hensley, which was the waste gunner, that I said, John, I said, you know, I don't drink at all. I said, I never drank alcohol. I said, I couldn't tell you what beer or whiskey or wine or alcohol tastes like. I said, when I'm in church and they give you communion, I don't take the wine. I said, they have to give me grape juice or apple juice. And I said, they can bless that just as well as they can bless that wine, or they can give me water. And I said, this John Hensley, I said, he was our waste gunner. And I said, he was a pretty good pub hopper. And I said, he drank that dark ale. I said, I don't know what kind of ale it is or what it is. I always told John he was in a stupor, half drunk, half all the time. I said, you'd have to be half drunk to be a waste gunner anyway. And I said, you have to be full drunk to be a ball turret gunner. I said, you had to be stupid to fly out there by all yourself. And I said, when we go on a mission, and I said, he flew 35 missions with me. And I said, at 9:30, you could set your watches on when he would want to go use that can for number two. And I said, one time, he forgot to put the paper bag, you know, that they've got it's a 5-gallon pail, it's metal. I said, but you got to put that paper. I said, we didn't have any plastic then. I said, we had paper bags that set right down in there, and you fold it over the top so that you, at 30,000 feet, that's pretty cool. And I said, as a kid, did you ever put your tongue to a steel pole or a pump handle or stuff and put your tongue to it when it's real cold? I said, what came off? I said, some of the skin on your tongue would come off. And I said, John Hensley would sometimes forget to put that bag around that. See, he'd sit on that, and they said he had a beautiful circle around his buttocks. And we'd always kid him, Circle John. So, but we, you know, you had your humorous moments when you do that. And when I got to tell you this little story now, the number two that he would do in this can, it was in this paper bag, and in front of the ball turret, they have an inspection little door that it's probably was 12 inches in diameter, and it had, it was on a hinge on the one side, and then on the other side, it was like a turnbuckle thing. You just turn it, and then you could lift it right up, and then when you close it, you just turned it back. And what that was for is that they had up in the bombardier's compartment, in the navigator's compartment, the pilot's compartment, if they had to do number one, take a leak, I said, then if they didn't tell me, and that ball turret glass where you look out with the guns, I said, if it was pointing forward, I said, then it was a mess. I said, it was a frozen, frosted mess at 30,000 feet. And then I said, somebody, the waste gunner, somebody had to get open that little vent door in front of the ball turret and try to clean the glass off. I said, sometimes they'd do a pretty good job. I said, most of the times, though, the pilots and the bombardier and the navigator and the co-pilot, they would tell me, Jack, now, and I'd say, are you stupid? You want to take that out at 30,000 feet? It's 50 below zero here. And pretty soon, there'd be a frozen stream coming back on my ball turret, you know, after it once hits the air. I mean, at 30,000 feet, 50 below zero, nothing's going to stay liquid. It's going to be solid. And it'd hit that front glass just like hail would hit, you know, a tin roof. But I'd always tell them they were pretty good. They would always tell me, "Hey, Jack, we gotta do number one. We'll turn your turret around to the back. Let it hit the back of your door." So that was kind of one of the humorous things. Most of the guys were pretty good about telling you, but every once in a while I give some of them heck for doing it. And they say, "Oh, we forgot." Well, you can forget just one time, fella, no more. But it's one of the humorous things that you get, and you got to have some of the stuff.